Okay, I found this old miner's coffee cup, metal coffee cup, laying up here outside these tunnels. That's a really cool find. You'll notice on the bottom there's two little holes that look like they were drilled in. They're too round, but who knows? But anyway, that is an old metal miner's coffee cup here at the 10-mile tunnel. Pioneer baking powder, 16 ounces net weight, guaranteed pure. That's an old baking powder can lid. Okay, here at the 10-mile tunnel, we found another portal, and we've come in here. You can see how badly eroded it is. And we came down here, and we thought the tunnel was blocked with this major collapse right here, all these big boulders. However, I came down a little further. It's always good to check everything out thoroughly, because I looked up and saw that we can get in. It's not sealed shut with a collapse. So let's go check out this second tunnel here at the 10-mile tunnel complex. And the tailings outside are huge here. I'll show you those later in the video. Massive tailings, a lot of structures, a lot of cabin foundations. So we're gonna check it out. Okay, there's looking back at the entry tunnel. We've climbed up over this pile of boulders into this little mini stope here at the entrance, and the tunnel continues over the boulders down there where Paul is. That's where I'm headed. Got to climb over this pile of big rocks and boulders, and that's where we're headed. The tunnel's right there. Okay, we noticed here in the tunnel walls what looks like gold, but it's not gold. It's pyrite. There's a lot of pyrite in these tunnel walls. You can see it sparkling everywhere. And then the tunnel does continue straight ahead there, and that's where we're headed. Here's a shot zooming down the tunnel there. Some minor collapses up there, but nothing major. So we're gonna head down there and check it all out.
Yeah, it looks like it might probably clears up.
Okay, so we're continuing down the tunnel here at the 10-mile tunnel, one of the other tunnels up here that we found. And so far it's a pretty big tunnel, pretty wide. And pretty straight, no turns yet.
Crumbly.
But very crumbly. I don't know if the pyrite's coming out in the video, but these walls are sparkling with pyrite. And it's pretty amazing. Little collapse right here. And we'll keep going this way.
I can't see that.
Here's a tree trunk timber. Something major here, I think. Must have been an ore body right there they dug out. Looks like a major collapse or something up here. Let's go check that out. So that's looking back towards the five-way intersection. We've come down the leftmost tunnel, and it comes down here to a backfilled area with a lot of heavy timbering here. You can see timbers back up in there, and we can get the rod there all the way underneath, so we would have to dig this out and to access the tunnel beyond. So we'll look at it a little more closely here.
Yeah, about that far past the timber. Yeah. 3 feet. 2.5 feet or so.
2.5 feet. Okay, back that way is the five-way intersection, and this is the only tunnel that is not a dead end. So, at least we think it's not a dead end. Looks like it wraps around here to the right. There's some kind of, that's got a metal platform on a wooden base. Don't know what that was used for. And there's a Y intersection right here. Here in the 10-mile tunnel. Wow, this is really cool. Tunnel goes that way, and tunnel goes this way. I believe this might be a dead end. Nope.
This keeps going.
Okay, the tunnel keeps going here. It's kind of winding all over the place. The rock here, you can see like right there, it's fracturing off. This mine is super crumbly. Very dangerous. We think it's very dangerous. We heard a...
Your light's on pointing back at me.
Yeah, the tunnels are very, I think this is the end.
I think I'm going to let it be a distance from this, just in case something goes up.
Wow, this is like a 360-degree turn, Paul.
Oh, really?
It's crazy. And it keeps going.
We're still heading back towards the...
That's almost like a 360-degree turn. I've never seen that in a mine.
I bet you there's going to be a connection to one of those projects. One of those prospects. Are you going here?
Not really. Is this the end? No, it's a 90 degree turn. And that's the end. End of the line. That was wild. Okay, we're here back at the Y intersection, and that tunnel there straight ahead goes back to the five-way intersection. So we're going to take the tunnel here around the corner that goes this way here in the 10-mile tunnel. Very sketchy.
Yeah, that's sketchy, mine.
Dude.
We got that.
So here's the end of this other branching tunnel. It doesn't go very far. It just ends right there at that little hole that you see. And that's it. You can see here in the overhead, don't know if it's coming out in the video, but all the scratch marks from the pickaxes. Don't know if you can see that in the video, but they're everywhere. This rock is so soft and crumbly, they didn't probably have to use dynamite. They just dug it with a pickaxe.
When you come back out here, I got a slab here that's going to come right off.
And that's looking back at Paul there. Okay, I'm zooming in over there to the far wall. We're back at the five-way intersection. You can see right there, all on that gray-colored rock. There you go. There you can see them. Those are pickaxe marks.
Check this out.